compound inequalities, special cases, or can give us all of a number line, or in other words, all real numbers. In interval notation, this would look like from negative infinity to infinity. And can give us none of the number line, or no solution, or in interval notation, it would look like the empty set. We don't usually use this in WalMap. Let's take a look at our first example. Let's get our x's on one side. And we get x plus 1 less than x minus 3. Whoops. Less than minus 3. Subtract 1, we get x is equal is less than negative 4. Or we're going to distribute here. We get 3x plus 3 greater than or equal to x minus 15. Subtract our x's out. I get 2x plus 3 greater than or equal to negative 15. Move our number over. We have 2x is greater than or equal to negative 18. Divide by 2, and x is greater than or equal to negative 9. So if we look at this on our number line, we've got negative 9 down here, and then negative 4. Our negative 4 is going to be an open dot. X is less than that, so that's going to negative infinity. X is greater than or equal to negative 9, so we're going to have a closed dot there. And X is greater than that, so that's going to positive infinity. So in this case, what that means for us, as far as our number line goes, is graphing this. This is going the whole thing. It's the whole graph, because we're going from negative infinity all the way to positive infinity. So again, in interval notation, we have parentheses negative infinity to positive infinity with a parenthesis. Let's take a look at example 2. We're going to start by distributing. We get negative 12x plus 3 less than or equal to 15. We'll subtract 3 from both sides. We get negative 12x is less than or equal to 12. We'll divide by negative 12. And x is going to be less than or equal to negative 1. I'll bring down my and, solve the other equation. We're going to get 2x is less than or equal to negative 6. Divide by 2, and we get that x is less than or equal to negative 3. So we've got negative 3 and a negative 1. We're going to have a closed dot at negative 1. And our x is less than or equal to negative 1. Whoops. I just realized, you guys have been probably being yelling at me, it should be greater than or equal to negative 1. So we're going to go into the positive infinity. We divided by a negative, so we have to change directions. And then we're going to have a closed dot at negative 3, and x is less than or equal to 3, so that's going to negative infinity. Now remember, with and, we have to have an overlap. We have no overlap, so that means our graph is just empty. There's nothing on it. And we either say that this is no solution, towards the empty set.